Hi everyone. In this session, I am going to discuss about the polymerization techniques. Now let us consider what is meant by polymerization techniques. Polymerization techniques are nothing but methods which are used to polymerize a particular monomer. There are four types of polymerization techniques. They are bulk polymerization, solution polymerization, suspension polymerization, and emulsion polymerization. So in this class, I am going to explain about each of these polymerization techniques in detail. The first one is the bulk polymerization. Bulk polymerization is also called mass polymerization. This bulk polymerization technique can be represented by this simple diagram. Bulk polymerization is carried out by adding a soluble initiator to pure monomer in a liquid state. That means the monomer and initiator should be taken in a liquid state and they should be soluble with one another. If necessary, the chain transfer agents can be used. It is to control the molecular weight, and the transfer agent, the chain transfer agent what we are using, that should also be soluble in monomers. The reaction is initiated by heating or exposing to radiation and kept under agitation for proper mass and heat transfer. As the reaction proceeds, the mixture becomes more viscous and mixing becomes progressively difficult. The reaction is exothermic and a wide range of molecular masses are produced. This process can be used for free radical polymerization and some step growth polymerization. So let us consider few examples. So we can prepare polystyrene from styrene using the bulk polymerization technique. Methyl methacrylate can be polymerized by the bulk polymerization technique, and PVC resins can be obtained by vinyl chloride by using the bulk polymerization technique. Now consider what are the advantages of this method. So by using a bulk polymerization, we can get a pure polymer. That means the polymer obtained by the bulk polymerization is pure. And the second advantage, the system is simple and requires thermal insulation. That means the system is very simple. The only need, it requires a thermal insulation. Then large casting may be prepared directly by the bulk polymerization technique. The molecular weight distribution can be easily changed with the use of chain transfer agents in case of bulk polymerization technique. And one more important advantage is the product obtained by this technique has high optical clarity. Then, what are the limitations associated with this method? It is highly exothermic, that means during the process, enormous amount of heat is produced. Heat transfer and mixing become difficult as the viscosity of reaction mass increases. The polymer obtained is with a broad molecular weight distribution due to the high viscosity and lack of good heat transfer. And one more limitation associated with this method is very low molecular weights are obtained. Sometimes the uncontrolled exothermic reactions of this bulk polymerization can lead to an explosion. So these are the limitations associated with the bulk polymerization. Now let me consider one more important technique, that is solution polymerization. It can be represented by this schematic diagram. So in this process, the monomer is dissolved in a suitable inert solvent along with the chain transfer agents wherever needed. The free radical initiator is also dissolved in the solvent medium for ionic and coordination polymerization. The solvent enhances the heat capacity, thereby it reducing the viscosity and promotes proper heat transfer. The mixture is kept at polymerization temperature. See, here I have mentioned it is supposed to be heat kept at the polymerization temperature and constantly agitated. The viscosity of solution does not increases with the concentration of monomer. After the reaction is over, the polymer is used as such in the form of polymer solution, or the polymer is isolated by evaporating the solvent. Polymer so formed by this technique can be used for surface coating. The best examples for the polymers, they can be prepared by the solution polymerization techniques, or polyacrylonitrile, polyacrylic acid, polyacrylamide, polyvinyl alcohol, polybutadiene, etc. So they can be prepared by using solution polymerization techniques. Then what are the advantages of this technique? First one, temperature control is easy. See, the solvents acts as a diluent and enolefin facilitating continuous transfer of heat of polymerization. Therefore, temperature control is easy. Viscosity buildup is negligible. The solvent allows easy stirring as it decreases the viscosity of reaction mixture. Solvent also facilitates the ease of removal of polymer from the reactor. Then the limitations of this technique. The first one, evaporate the solvent to get a pure polymer. That means to get pure polymer, evaporation of solvent is required additional technology. So it is essential to separate and recover the solvent. The method is costly since it involves the use of costly solvents. Polymers of high molecular weight cannot be formed as the solvent molecules may act as chain terminators here. The purity of product is also not as high as that of bulk polymerization because removal of lost traces of solvent is difficult. So these are the limitations associated with the solution polymerization. Now the third one is suspension polymerization. This method was developed to control the enormous amount of heat releases in the bulk polymerization. Now you just look at this schematic diagram which represents the process of suspension polymerization. So only water insoluble monomer can be polymerized by this technique. The monomer is suspended in the form of fine droplets in the water. You just observe here, the monomer is suspended in the form of a fine droplet in water, which are stabilized and prevented from coalescing by using suitable stabilizers. The size of the droplets formed depends on the monomer water ratio, the type and concentration of stabilizing agents, and speed of the agitations employed. Each of these droplets acts like tiny bulk reactors. Here, heat transfer occurs from the droplets to the water, having large heat capacity and low viscosity. As the entire bulk of the monomer is divided into innumerable tiny particles or tiny droplets, control of the kinetic chain length of the polymer is also quite good. So, the product has a narrow molecular weight distribution. The polymerization takes place inside the droplet and product formed being insoluble in water. The polymerization proceeds to almost 100% conversion and the product is obtained as a spherical beads or pearls. So this technique is also known as bead or pearl polymerization. So you just observe, so within the droplet of water only the monomers are there, then they get polymerized within the droplet. The best examples for the polymers which are synthesized or prepared by the suspension polymerization technique are polyvinyl acetate, polystyrene, styrene, divinyl benzene copolymer, etc. Now let us consider the advantages of this method, that is suspension polymerization. The process is comparatively cheap as it involves only water instead of any solvents like solution polymerization. Viscosity increase is negligible here. Agitation and temperature control is very easy. The product isolation is easy since the product is insoluble in water. Now let us consider the limitations of this technique. The method can be adapted only for water-insoluble monomers. So, water-soluble monomers cannot be polymerized by this technique. It is difficult to control polymer size. The polymer purity is low due to the presence of suspending and stabilizing additives that are difficult to remove completely. The method cannot be used for tacky polymers. So these are the limitations associated with the suspension polymerization. Now you consider one more important polymerization technique, that is emulsion polymerization. This is the most widely used method of polymerization in which the monomer is dispersed in an aqueous space as a fine droplets, which are then stabilized or emulsified by surface active agents. The surfactants can be cationic or non-ionic. A water-soluble initiators are used. Here, the surfactants serves the purpose of lowering the surface tension at the monomer water interface and facilitate emulsification of the monomer in water. The surfactant will form micelles. See, this is the micelle. The surfactant molecules will be having lyophobic tile and lyophilic head. So during the formation of micelle, it is arranged in such a way that the lyophobic parts are directed inward and lyophobic heads are directed outwards. It is towards the aqueous phase. When their concentration exceeds critical micelle concentration, that are dispersed throughout the solution. The interior of the micelles, it is most important, the interior of the micelle acts as a hydrocarbon phase where the monomer can be stabilized. So the monomer can be stabilized within these micelles. Now you consider the technique. When the monomer is added and agitated, so the monomer is indicated by the green dot, initiators are indicated by the black dot, and surfactants are indicated by blue dot with a tile. So when the monomer is added and agitated, emulsification takes place. The resultant emulsion is a complex system where a molecular solution of the emulsifier in water is the continuous phase. See, it is a continuous phase wherein the monomer droplets and micelles, so which are having solubilized monomer at their interior, are uniformly distributed. Emulsion system generally utilize a water soluble initiators. With the more and more polymer formation, the polymer aggregate into fine particles, get surrounded and then stabilized by the emulsifier layer of the micelles. At the end of polymerization, the fine particles of the polymer stabilized by the emulsifier and dispersed uniformly in the aqueous layer. This milky white dispersion is called latex. The latex either can be used for making adhesives, water soluble emulsion paints, etc. The polymer can be isolated from the latex by destabilizing the emulsion using some electrolyte by spraying, drying or freezing. The best examples for the polymers which can be prepared by these techniques are synthetic rubber, styrene butadiene, polybutadiene, polychloroprene, etc. Now let us consider the advantages of this technique. High molecular weight polymers can be made at fast polymerization rates using this emulsion polymerization. Easy heat control and easy agitation are involved in this technique. The viscosity remains close to water and is not dependent on molecular weight. The final product can be used as such, does not need to be altered or processed. Then the limitations of this technique. For dry polymers or isolated polymers, water removal is an energy intensive process. It is difficult to eliminate entrenched coagulants, emulsifiers, surfactants. And it is designed to operate at high conversion of monomer to polymer. This can result in significant chain transfer to polymer. So these are the limitations associated with the emulsion polymerization. So far, I have explained about the four important polymerization techniques, that is bulk polymerization, solution polymerization, suspension polymerization and emulsion polymerization, along with the advantages and limitations of each technique. Hope you understood them. Thank you very much.